activities, in your physical activities, in your educational activities, in anything you are doing, in your religious activities, focus on God.
When you know it, that is only God that cannot fail in your life, then your life will be very smooth. Focus on God. That is when you can be a good disciple. That is when you can be a good follower of God. Your trust in life must not be in any man. Any man can fail you, including your father and mother. I want to repeat it again. Any man can fail you, including your father and mother. It is only God that cannot fail you. It is God that can say, I will visit you 7 a.m. and you will see that 7 a.m. You will see the anointing of God in all you are doing. It is God that can say, keep quiet. On Friday, 9th of December, I am going to give you a Jeep. You will see a Jeep. Like, that is how God is. He's not a man that he will lie. That no, he is a son of man that he will be repenting. No. When he says, let there be light, there was light. Somebody say light. That light will shine in every area of your life in the name of Jesus. A disciple is one who has made up his mind to go all the way with Jesus. There are people who desire to go up into him in all things, unto the fullness of his statures in every way. Not in one way. Not when there is food. Not when there is money. Not when people love you. The whole world can hate you. Follow you, make sure you follow Jesus. It doesn't matter the opinion. It doesn't matter the understanding that is derogatory to the master plan of God over your life. It doesn't matter the level of your opposition can be life. You have to be a good disciple and follow Jesus. When you look at some issues in your life, when you meditate and you just ponder on it, you will know that there is no remedy. There is no impediment in following Christ. Your interest might be jeopardized in the social setup, of the community. Or in your own, in your own level. But I want to assure you, there is a future for you.
Amen.
I said, there is a future for you.
Amen.
Somebody is here, there is hope for you.
Amen.
Somebody is here, you are advancing.
Amen.
I want to tell you, there is a good news for somebody here.
Amen.
You will be surprised and amazed at how you are going to spend your Christmas. Amen. Because this will be a unique one for you.
Amen.
If you believe, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
A disciple is the first of all someone who is born again. You have to be born again. How do you born again? It's not that you enter your mother's belly and come out again. No. You must repent from your sin and separate yourself from sin. That is the meaning of being born again. Praise the Lord. Except a man is born again, he has no potential of becoming like Jesus. A lizard cannot grow up to become a crocodile, no matter the feeding, training, and exposure. Likewise, a sinner, no matter the principle of discipleship applied, cannot be like Jesus. You ought to forgive people. They can offend you 1 million times. Forgive them. Give them that gap. Give them the grace. If they offend you 1 million times, you must get ready to forgive them. You must know a point yardstick in which you measure your morality to people. Those who are fault finder, finding your fault, they will do for you, they will not get you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You have to be a good disciple. The most critics of Jesus Are you hearing me? If you get to Jerusalem, we were there, your daddy and I. When you see the level, the capacity, the magnitude of the people coming to Jerusalem, even those who have already criticized Jesus, wherever they are, when they see the kind of visitors, they will know that, no, this is not ordinary. So it doesn't matter who doesn't like you. You don't even be thinking of them, of those things. Be focused and focus on Jesus. Praise the Lord. A disciple is an ear of God in training under tutors and governors until the appointment time by his father, when he will be matured enough to possess his possession. They are under training, under tutelage, under tutors, under instructors, until they are full grown, until they are able to discern and know their rights from the wrong, and know what it is to do and the one they should not do, and know their level. When you know your level, you will behave yourself. When you know your level, you will not come and be following Kwamba boys. For what? You don't need it. You know your level. You come to Kwamba and be running after girls. That means something. A key has got wrong in your brain. When you watch our daddy here, he's a good example to follow. They were telling me one day, they said, that your husband does not greet women, no, anyhow. I said, for what? What? Please give him a big round of applause. They said, when he wants to greet you, he say, good evening, how are you? How is your husband? And he will walk away. Yes! He knows his level. He knows what he stands for. And he knows his credibility. Your integrity cannot be overemphasized wherever you find yourself. Either local or international level. It doesn't matter. What matters is what is in you. And what is in you is Christ in you, the hope of your glory. Praise the Lord. When I was outside the country, one foreigner moved closer to me. A foreigner moved closer to me. He said, are you married? He said, are you married? I said, I am married. He said, are you married? I said, I am married. Immediately I said, I am married. He moved away. Praise the Lord. Don't let your birthright be taken with a means of bread and butter. The Lord will help you in Jesus' name. Amen. A disciple is the one who voluntarily yields his life to the service of his master to be nurtured by him. The master's lifestyle, will, and body become that of the disciple. Where the master goes, it is where the disciple will follow. They are yoked together. You have to look up to Jesus. That's why we are telling you, look unto Jesus, the author and finisher of your faith. Follow the activities, follow the lifestyle of Jesus. Your parents, to watch your parents. Watch your parents. Your father is a very good example. Your mother is an example. Watch them and see how they do. Humble yourself. Don't be a proud person. And God will help us in Jesus' name. A disciple is a person with singular focus under one master. How many master? How many master?
One.
Under one master. He does not live a double life. Every personal ambition is gone.
Yes,
He lives solely for the master. Solely for the master. Ambition is there, but when you live for Jesus, you will find out that God will take up that ambition and make it more beautiful. I could remember when I was trying, growing up, I wanted to be a lawyer. And all of a sudden, when I had to go for nursing, I told them that I want to study law. Why am I here? But I want to thank God that today that I still went to the university for law. So the knowledge is still there. Are you hearing me? No knowledge is wasted in life. Whatever you are studying is not wasted. And that is why you must develop yourself. They call something capacity building and capability building. Development. Capability. Development. And that is why you must stand out. You don't have to be a local champion. You have to stand out. You have first degree. Yes, congratulations. Some people have 10 degrees and they're still existing. Why not ask for more and go for more? So that you can be more relevant in your generation. The more you study, the more you are enlightening. And your mental horizon will be broadened. Reading is very important because the joy of reading is a joy forever. When you read, it illuminates your mind. When you read, you are enlightened. You are informed. You are not a novice. You are not ignorant of what is happening around you. My mother of a blessed memory will say, "Refra ingritate," or something like that. When you don't know something, you don't know. When you know it, you know it. And when you know it, you are loaded. Even when you are smiling, what is in you? You'll just be sizing the situation up because you can handle that situation. Yes. People feel that if you are in the ministry, you don't know anything. Somebody like me, if I look at somebody, I will know. My law of evidence will give me what I need to know. Criminal law will be talking. Constitutional law will be talking. Legal system will be talking. Law of contract will be talking for me. I will just, when the situation happens, we call it scenario. When you see a scenario, you know what is coming out of it. And you will know how to mastermind it. If it is on the medical field, if there is any wound now, I can know that this one is an abrased wound. This one is a contused one. Then I will know the application of what to do. The one I know that it needs stitching, I will know that I will have to go to a clinic for them to stitch it for me. You must know what surrounds you. And how do you know? You must be a reader. A reader is a leader. When you are not reading, you are not a leader. You cannot lead a butterfly. When you are the one that studies, when you are talking, they know that you are an authority in that field. That field of socialization. And that is why you should develop yourself as a good disciple. Study your Bible. Go to into encyclopedias. Google some things. We have sociology, dictionary at home. We have the psychology, we have the law, we have the medicine. So which one do you want to study? You bring it out and get meaning of words. And when you have developed yourself to a level and you go out, you know that you are an asset, not only for yourself, but for your generation at large. A disciple. A disciple is a learner who has voluntarily conceded authority to the teacher. You are a learner. Do you know my age? I am still a learner. And throughout my life, I remain loyal to be a learner. Because I want to have an university in life. Because I have a purpose of living. And that is why I will never stop learning. If you allow me to, tomorrow, I'll still go back to the university again. And still study more. There is a lot for you to learn. There is a lot for you to see. There is a lot for you to enhance. You must be a good learner. You must not be proud for anything. You have BSc. Fine, congratulations. You can still have your master's, you can have your PhD. You can be a professor. Yes. The disciple drinks from the wisdom of his teacher. He stays through the process of learning. I could remember when I had to put on uniform, white and black, to the university. I would wear my sandals. I must not be late to class. All those. And the discipline was too much. But today it is joy. It will be much more joy for you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Somebody will say, why do we have to run to Abuja for income? We have to go, because when we go, we learn there. We sit down, we learn. And when we learn, we come back light, because you're already loaded with information. There are many information that I have gotten through that channel. And it's helping. Somebody say it's helping.
Yeah.
So you have to be a good learner. If you are not a learner, you cannot teach. What do you want to pass across to your next generation? How do you want to train the next generation if you are not a learner? You have to be a good learner. A disciple does not choose how his master trains him. He submits himself to his trainer obediently in all things. Somebody say, in all things.
In
all things. He accepts joyfully the master's decision. Something happened on Saturday. We were in a place. And the archbishop said they should tell us to leave that place. We all left. Me, your daddy, your other bishops, we left. And, you know, by the time we got to the other, where we are, the preaching came. The preaching was already a comfort to our soul. And by the time the meeting ended, we ended it joyfully. Praise the Lord. You must accept correction. You must be teachable. You must be somebody that when you are being corrected, you don't find fault or grudges. Praise the Lord. A disciple loves his master. He is loyal to him. Praise the Lord. You have to love your master. Love your master. Be loyal. I was in South Africa, and the way I was speaking about Ilko, all the pastors were looking at me. Yes, because I am loyal to Ilko. You have to be loyal. Be loyal in your house. Be loyal in your community. Be loyal outside. Be loyal in your university. When you are loyal, you get the best results. And the best is going to be yours in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Rise up on your feet and begin to give thanks to God.